Hello everyone, it is time for another build on the model show. We do this at least twice a week. We do full kit builds. This will be from the personal stash, a kit I just picked up from a favorite online retailer. You'll have to check out, just do some Google searches to see where it's available. This is the newest Batmobile from the movie The Batman. It's built by BanDai. It's in 1/35th scale, and the reason for the 1/35th scale instead of 1/24th or 1/25th is because of the massive available diorama possibilities. He drives through kind of a utopian city and stuff. There are plenty of figures and buildings and road scenes and military vehicles in that 1/35th scale, and that's why BanDai went with that for this vehicle so that you can incorporate it into other things. I happen to enjoy the latest Batman movie. When I first heard Robert Pattinson, whatever his name is, was going to be the new Batman, I'm like, oh man, he's kind of a Streisand. I've seen one of those Twilight movies. I couldn't even get all the way through it. I thought it was terrible. But I really enjoyed the Batman, and the car was cool. It was like a Charger, Camaro, just ultimate machine mix, but it looked like something that could really be driven in the real world. So let's take a look at a BanDai kit. If you haven't ever purchased or built a BanDai kit, whether it be one of their military kits, one of their sci-fi kits like a Gundam, one of their Star Wars kits, you're really doing yourself a disservice because these kits are amazing. First up in the parts trees will be these sweet looking tires. There is no name on the tires, but they have a gorgeous performance street tread, and they are a squishy rubber texture. Nice looking. They should just push right on. Speaking of push right on, most BanDai kits are a press together type kit. No glue is usually needed at all, and everything fits seamlessly. These BanDai kits, I am going to go out on a limb and say, are the best design model kits on the planet to date. They are just so precise. We have an entire silver tree here with engine and turbine parts. We've got exhaust outlets that you can see right there on the model. This thing is quite BA, BA for badass. We got disc brakes. We got the turbine right there. We've got turbochargers. All of this just looks spectacular. Check out the headers on that thing. A lot of times you can just build these kits right from the box and they build up lovely. We're even going to take a look at the instruction manual. Since I don't cover a lot of BanDai kits on the show, we'll see how nice these are. There's a color guide in here, pretty much just three colors, silver, gray, and black if you wanted to paint any accents. The inside will give you a full parts breakdown. Then it will go in Japanese and English, letting you build the kit. It is very, very easy to build BanDai kits. You do not get confused. They are very, very clear. They fold out nicely, and they show you how to take care of everything and how to push things together. Now we'll switch to the remaining parts in the kit, which are cast in a very nice, I say very a lot for these, satin black, not a smooth texture. This is the car. I mean, that's how the car looked. So you wouldn't even need to paint this. It would look awesome. Here are the wheels. Now the wheels, you might want to throw a little bit of paint on to, you know, get them different than the body. But otherwise, our grill, our work, and a lot of this will work out with a good dry brushing when we're done. All the separate jagged body panels look so awesome on here. They're labeled very clearly on the trees. The detail, look at that fine, fine detail. Lovely. The hood right there is a tough looking character. Molded excellently. Check out all the fine details in the grills for the lights. We've got our roof panel here. A little dust on the box, but I mean, even these, like, these little marks here are supposed to be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the other four with the mark there, like little weld or rivet marks, but they're so finely detailed. We got the awesome looking roll cage, chassis components. Here's the frame. I mean, and what's cool about BanDai is they're doing modern subjects of movies we're seeing right now. Right now, like the AMT Razor Crest, it's stuff that's on the market immediately. Here we've got our trailing arm suspension in the rear. We've got our interior pan, driver's seat. Look at the dashboard. And something unique about BanDai kits is they will mold clear parts, colored parts, different color parts, all on the same tree. Their mold making is second to none. We got that awesome steering wheel. You can see in 1/35 scale, it's not going to be that small of a vehicle. Got our transparent red tail lights. Got our shifters. These will all lend themselves to some hand painting. Same with the suspension. Got that windshield design to just snap in. Crystal clear. And our headlights. And that is it. That's all the parts that are in the 1/35 scale BanDai, the Batman Batmobile version. I am going to start putting mine together right now. Thank you. as I expected in the beginning, and I didn't want to get ahead of myself, but I did think this was going to be quite an easy build as far as fit goes so far. And so far, you know, knock on wood, tap my skull, everything has gone together exactly as good as I thought it would, as long as you pay attention. The only time something doesn't go in right is when I'm not paying attention to the directions close enough, and I should have reversed the position or whatnot. But we've got our hood assembled with its intakes. I am not going to use any paint on the body panels. I've cut the roof free from the sprue. That satin black is just perfect. There's no, it looks like the movie, and it doesn't really look like plastic too much that it'll throw it off. It looks like a nice material on there, like a carbon fiber painted satin black or whatever they used. And so that's just going to be left alone. Those body panels are going to be left alone. I am going to paint the chassis and the roll cage. The roll cage itself, I want to give a complete dead black, flat black look to it on the inside of that body. So we've got that out here on its trees so we can get that painted. I also want to paint the wheels. Since they are black and the body will be a satin black, I want them to contrast, so these will get painted flat black. And I may even do a little dry brushing to bring those out, show maybe a little wear to them. But the chassis here will be fine. The nose is part of those body panels, so that I'm leaving alone. You can see we've already got the headlights in. This stuff just snaps in place. We've got a steerable front end that works perfectly. It's a nice tight fit. So you can still move it, but it's not flopping around and it doesn't fall apart when you get it together. We've got our rear drive line that's snapped into place. Here's a hint about BanDai kits. If it's not fitting, you are doing something wrong. They are engineered that well. So if they don't fit in, stop, look at the directions, look at them again, and there's just something you're missing. It's just a slight mistake. The trailing arms and shocks, I want to get a coat of paint on these. I want them to stand out a little bit more than that gray plastic. I want them to look metallic, so that's what I want with mine. The tires, I'm going to give a shot of flat acrylic. Use acrylic on rubbery items. If you use enamels, they most likely will never dry for you. It's just a physical property of the plastic. We've got the exhaust or the turbo coupler back here with that little ring we put on. We got the exhaust intakes here, and the brake discs and the calipers. Check out the detail on those brake discs. I want to get some paint on this and make them a little brighter to stand out and blackwash them. Same with the exhaust, because the exhaust kind of stands out on the real car. We've got our turbo set up here in multiple pieces, and this is going to be so cool to get some metallic work on and do these in different shades, metallics, black washing. We got our exhausts here. So I'm gonna get all different shades of metallics on here, maybe use a little blue, a little orange, get them painted up. We got our engine with our massive headers coming out. Look at that thing. Big honking V8. We're gonna get this painted. We're gonna get it metallicized. We're gonna detail it so it stands out. The interior is just gonna get a flat coat so we can dead flat that part there. And then my idea is to gloss the steering wheel seat and dashboard and then go in and detail the gauges. Since there are no decals, we can use some paint markers and some gel pens and stuff for our throttle and our shifter. We can get a little bit of detail so we can look inside. It's mostly a stealth vehicle in black, but they still want to see some small stuff inside. So I'm going to get everything over to paint now. You can see how I get color on it. Thank you. Well, holy cow, am I having a good time. This is such a sweet kit. I wish BanDai made a lot of like modern vehicles and stuff like that that we could build, because not only can you paint and detail them, but they go together so nice. Even with paint on them, the parts slip together so easily. Look at this chassis. This thing is tough. We can turn the tires. They're directional, so make sure you make two lefts and two rights. They just push over the wheels. I did dry brush those wheels, as you saw, and now they stand out. They look a little nicer instead of just being black wheels. We got that sweet hood pressed in. We got the grill. I did dry brush the metallic a little bit on those front bumpers there from nudging the bad guys. Look at that V8 in the back. Oh, that thing is so tough with the little bat wings on the cage coming out the back. There's our little itty-bitty taillights. Got our exhaust all squeezing between all the fuselage parts and all that. Got our turbo intakes. The turbo intakes are right behind his head, so good thing he's got that helmet on or he'd be completely deaf with the howl of that wind. The dashboard looks sweet. We detailed that thing up and made it look good. And now all I have to do after these steps, we can see our shocks with our reservoirs on them and everything. I mean, they didn't miss a beat. And it's not that small. It's 1/35 scale, but it's not teeny tiny. The windshield even went in. I mean, you saw that. It just pressed in tight and fits in. And now we just have to put the roof on and snap on six body panels. They're just going to press on from the outside. Push our exhaust in. Once we get all the body panels on, we have these two little spoilers / reinforcement bars across the back, and then the windshield wipers. The end of the instructions make the black on black work super easy because they go to a color presentation. Not going to have any issues. So far, a joy to build. I anticipate it's going to be just as awesome. I wanted to give you a look at that chassis and that engine. We'll cover a lot of it up, but I'm pretty sure we'll still be able to see most of that engine and how cool it looks with the multiple metallics. But when I come back, she'll be on the turntable because we'll have our final. Here we go, running around on the new turntable. Did you guys notice I got a new turntable recently? Well, hope it works better than the old one. It's got the felt top. I picked this up on Amazon for like 20 bucks. You can find electric turntables on there all over. Anyways, we've got BanDai's 1/35 scale, the Batman Batmobile, the one with Robert Pattinson in it. This is a sweet, sweet, sweet build. I love modern engineering on model kits. It makes building such a joy. You want to know how much of a joy this is? This entire kit, including the unboxing, the painting, the detailing, and the assembly, this entire video was filmed in one day for a gorgeous, extremely screen accurate Batmobile. How awesome is that? I heard BanDai makes other Batmobile kits. I gotta get them because this is crazy good. And maybe we'll build them on the show if you guys like this video enough. So let me know. You wanna see more BanDai kits like this on the show? I'd love to get them. The model is just, there's nothing bad to say about it. From start to finish, from step one till the final step, this kit goes together gorgeously. The Japanese can design a model kit. They really can. They can build cars. They can build motorcycles. They can build model kits. Their Star Wars kits are gorgeous. Their Batman kits are, well, obviously this is the only one I can speak for, but this one is phenomenal. I mean, look at the detail on that engine on a kit that just presses together. That's why I don't like to say snap tight or snap fit. The old snap tights of the old days, not that high quality, you know, iffy. You can make them look pretty darn good, though. I'm going to have some more coming up on the show. But this, what I like to say is press fit, meaning engineered so well, doesn't need a drop of glue, holds tight, has a ton of detail, and with just a little bit of paintwork, you can see how I changed the color of that dashboard with the gloss, with the interior the way it is. It stands out. We painted that engine with multiple metallics, made the headers and the exhaust and the turbos look like they've been heat stained. We got our exhaust here, black washes, a little bit of dry brushing. We got underneath, looks so awesome with the chassis and the suspension and everything. It's got steerable wheels. It's just awesome sauce all the way around. So I'm really glad I picked up this kit. You can just Google around or wherever you can find it. If there's a link, if Model Roundup or someone starts to carry a kit like this, I will link in the description where you can snag it for them. Otherwise, Thanks for watching the workshop. If I ever built this kit again, which would be kind of cool, I would, all the body panels are on like one tree and everything snaps. I painted a different color, like as if the Joker got a hold of it, and the purple and the green and the Joker mobile and bright green wheels or something like that. I think that would look awesome. And beat it up a little more. Use some heat to press in the body panels and stuff and crack the glass, because obviously you'd have to pretty much destroy it to get it away from Batman. So anyways, as always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models for you. Smile, have a good time, and we'll see all of you at the next review.